Hi Taapsee, nice to see you back in Tamil again.
Thank you.
So tell me about this movie Game Over. This is your first film in three languages for the first time.
Yeah.
Combining North and South.
Yeah.
So how do you feel about that?
I think I feel very lucky that I can be a pan-India actor. I feel the lines need to blur between North and South, and especially where cinema is concerned, because I think we are an Indian audience at the end of the day, and great work is happening both sides. So I think the audience deserves to watch the cinema that's getting made here and there at the same time. So if I can be one of those reasons or vehicle for the change, I think I'm very privileged and lucky.
So tell me something about this role. You're playing a character called Swapna, and she's homebound, at least that's what we see.
She's not homebound, she's going through post-trauma stress disorders, because of which she doesn't like to go out much and likes to work from home and all of that. So yeah, there are certain limitations mentally and then eventually physically also, because she gets wheelchair bound. So there were a lot of limitations physically and mentally, which made this very challenging for me to do, because I really rely on my agility as a person, my body language and all, and I really rely on the energy I can bring in. But here, both things were taken away from me. I was impaired physically to sit in the wheelchair for 60% of the film, and mentally also my energy was taken away because I'm a trauma victim. So in spite of these limitations, I had to hold the screen for at least 90-95% of the film, which I think becomes a true test for an actor. I'll get to know on June 14th if I've passed it or not.
And what is her profession?
She's a video game programmer, so she programs and plays. She plays vintage video games. She programs the high-tech modern video games, but she plays vintage video games.
See, in some of your other films, you've had to learn martial arts or shooting and things like that. So in this film, there was nothing like that.
No, I didn't have to learn anything particularly. I had to just be ready to psych my brain out into believing that I'm a trauma victim, which is, I think, slightly more brutal than learning something new, like a sport or an activity or anything. Because here, when I'm psyching my brain out into believing I'm a trauma victim for 35 days, I will never be able to come out of it 100%. And some part of it will always stay with me for the rest of the life. That's the cost you pay to be an actor. Yeah.
So you've still not come out of it?
No. Every film I do, most of my films have intense layered characters. So every film I do, after that I change a little bit as a person. Sometimes for the good, sometimes for the bad. But a thing changes in me and I can't do anything about it.
See, this is a home invasion thriller, as the director said. So there's no reference point, he said, for this. So how did you, where did you work on? Was it collaborative with the director?
I loved the script. And that was a good thing that there was nothing no reference to it, because that's what excited me, because there's no reference to this kind of stuff. It's first of its kind. That is what excited me to do the film at first place. And then I'm a director's actor. I blindly go with the director. Once I'm okay with the script, I surrender myself to the director. I don't even see monitors.
And so you're looking forward to your next project in Hindi. Can you tell us?
After this, Mission Mangal on 15th August, and post that, I have a Diwali release with Saan Ki Aankh.
So it's going to be a very busy year for you.
And it has been in the last couple of years. I've had five releases last year, four this year. I'll have four next year as well.
Thank you so much. All the best.
Thank you.